Today is a great day for individualized physical therapy. Backed by 30-plus years of professional excellence, make every day a great day at Genesee Valley Physical Therapy.
Genesee Valley Physical Therapy.
Maybe yet,
Bob. Choose a school where the arts are aligned.
I'm
telling you now,
all that to create something extraordinary.
The hunter uniform or whatever it was.
You choose. GCC gives you the tools to start your next journey. Because when you choose GCC, your time is now.
If only they could be with me.
Hello, you're watching.
It's one of the most important aspects of your life. And we're here
to help you
save every day on a wide range of comfort styles from the best brands. You'll find the right mattress for you. Guarantee it. Come in today and comfort test a Beauty Rest Black mattress for a chance to win a $20,000 home makeover.
Hawaiian Jones.
We deliver your new mattress the very next day and take all your old mattress for free. Ray Warren Flanagan is the place for your best rest ever.
Okay.
Yeah.
Victory can be capable. Think again.
Huh.
I won't stay.
Introducing the first ever
1743 on Dynasty Harbor and Tours. That's for a wedding.
Was in the Philippines, you had thousands of shoes. You're gonna be like Imelda Marcos?
No.
Is that what it is?
The IDC dog meaty board. Meaty board. I don't think my dad can get into these small movies. The birthday is I want to pet everyone. The birthday. They've got like the main souls.
There definitely is an end to this point, but we will have to get through yet one more day where we do have to keep effective advisors and
effective
tomorrow. But we're also seeing right now.
If you get these, or when you get these, shoes of the rock shoes, will you actually
wherever you are, on RochesterFirst.com, Facebook, Twitter, and on our app for news and weather.
Which color are you getting the red with the white sole?
How many U.S. citizens are still trying to leave? Flights leading couple every 39 minutes.
Okay, who's red heel or orange heel?
To get CIA personnel to the airport.
Jeez, 185 Canadians. It's only like $50 a year.
And our exclusive interview with the top U.S. diplomat in Afghanistan.
Yeah, it's still around
the bottom. The Americans not out by the deadline. The COVID battle. Pediatric hospitalizations in the South reach a new high. White Health officials said it's only going to get worse. Plus, if you got the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, news tonight about a booster shot. In our back-to-school series, the search for 3 million students nationwide who haven't been to school in a year.
Nursing house, yeah.
Landlord,
it's time to die!
Oh, I see it now. Pure waste.
And humidity. The 95 million Americans who face extreme temperature. Plus, Tahoe now has the worst air pollution in the country.
Oh, Tahoe.
Lake Tahoe.
All the smog, all the boats, RVs, everything.
Oh yeah, the Paralympics?
Final days, we have just learned tonight.
that the U.S. military is specifically American outside of the Kabul airport, using helicopters and even some ground troops. About 4,500 Americans have been pulled out of the country so far, and the State Department now says it has a clearer idea of how many remain, and is desperately trying to contact them. So in a moment, we will speak with the top U.S. diplomat in Afghanistan about what happens to Americans who do not get out before the president called his 31st deadline to withdraw U.S. forces. For now, the military flight out of Kabul continues. All told, more than 88,000 people have been evacuated since July. But tonight, the biggest threat to this historic evacuation is a real and immediate threat. U.S. officials warning the terrorist group ISIS-K has the ability to attack the airport. CBS's Nancy Cordes is going to lead us off tonight from the White House. Good evening, Nancy.
Good evening, Laura. Tonight we are learning that the military has been conducting more emergency missions to rescue both American citizens and CIA personnel outside of the Kabul airport using choppers to do so. Today, the Secretary of State saying that of the 6,000 or so Americans who were in Afghanistan at the start of the month, about three quarters of them have now been evacuated.
This is very high risk.
Secretary Blinken said the State Department has contacted about 500 Americans in the past 24 hours, giving them instructions on how to get
to
the But that leaves about 1,000 Americans whose wishes and status are unclear.
We're aggressively reaching out to them multiple times a day through multiple channels of communication, phones, email, text messages, to determine whether they still want to leave. To get the most up-to-date information and instructions to them for how to do so.
More than 70,000 Afghans have now been evacuated, but thousands more lost sewage and waiting makeshift camps outside Kabul Airport as soldiers guard the walls. Reporter Sikandar Karmani from our partner BBC spoke to some who have the papers.
Fuck you.
And many don't. We've been waiting here for 6 days and 6 nights. The American Embassy told us to come here, but we can't get past all these crazy people. There's no way we can stay here. The Americans should ship us or return to us. There are also reports of Afghans being beaten or forced to pay bribes by Taliban fighters as they try to get into the airport. Even as Pentagon officials insist, the Taliban is cooperating.
Not saying it's been perfect, but by and large, the people that we have made clear to the Taliban that we want to have access to the terminal have been able to get through.
But he had choice words today for two unannounced airport visitors.
Oh, what the crap!
Bolton and Republican Peter Meyer, who flew there yesterday.
By the way, what we have been able to do that day.
The two congressmen called it oversight. Some of their colleagues called it a stunt. The Secretary of State insisted today that the U.S. will continue to help Americans and qualified Afghans get out of the country.
Oh, bullshit.
The U.S. military departs in 6 days, but he was intentionally vague about how the U.S. plans to pull that off
once
all the troops are gone. Nancy Gordon, thank you. The Russian now our exclusive interview with the top U.S. diplomat in Afghanistan earlier today. He spoke with Ambassador Ross Gordon. He's no longer at the embassy in Kabul. He's dead working on that airport. We asked him about the Americans still in the country.
Fuck!
We've been working our way through.
Did we get it? Yeah! Run.
It would not fire.
I spawned halfway. I got shot through. Got you. I was spawned. Today. You're gonna die on me anyway.
The question has been raised. Why didn't the U.S. get out Americans and our Afghani friends before
Oh snap, I didn't even realize we got the kill cam.
Oh, what the hell? He said a couple are going. Oh crap, I ran out of bullets.
We need a spawn flip.
To where?
Spawning on A, I think. Yep, it's there. Go get it, go get it, go get it, go get it. I got it. Oh, sorry, Shifty. I'm in the tunnel.
Okay.
Yeah, he's with the wood pile. Nice.
Where are they?
They're on B, and I got shot from C.
I got them.
So I put this one, now my shit's wasted. And I died.
I got a firebombing run.
Antibodies against the virus jumped 9 times higher with a second shot. Federal approval still requires
I'm gonna stay in here. So I don't sizzle myself.
Triple! Long flip. Get it.
How did I get, hit markers with a firebombing run?
Have a headshot. You don't shoot my people. Oh shit. I'm reloading, they're out back. Damn, I got stuck reloading and gassed.
Erica Jones has 2 kids, including her first grader, Kenley. She's also president of the Mississippi Association of Educators. The group now urges a massive mandate in all schools.
CBS's Carter Evans now on America's Lost Media.